This problem, we have a well-insulated piston and cylinder that's empty, and we have pressure on this cylinder, 6/10 of a megapascal, and then the cylinder is connected to a fixed volume tank that's also well-insulated, and we're given there are 5 moles of air in the tank, we're given pressure and temperature, and then the valve between the cylinder and the tank is cracked until the pressure is the same in both containers. Then it's closed again. And we measure the final temperature in the tank, 480 Kelvin. And the question is, what's the final temperature in the cylinder? It's going to be a different temperature. And to solve this problem, let's use a constant heat capacity of 28.8 joules per mole per Kelvin. First thing we want to do is draw a diagram to represent the system. So on the left, we're representing the system. The cylinder piston arrangement is empty. We have the gas in our tank. At a later time, we have fewer moles. So in T, that's going to be the number of moles of air that's in the tank at the end. The pressure now is going to be the same as the pressure because we have the valve open. The pressures are going to equalize between the two tanks. We've measured this temperature in the tank as 480. What we don't know is the temperature in the piston and cylinder. This is what we want to calculate. So we're going to use a combination of ideal gas law and energy balance to do this calculation. So we're going to need to know how many moles are in the tank at the end. And to do this, first let's determine the tank volume. And we can do this because, assume this is an ideal gas, we have the pressure, the temperature, and the number of moles. So the tank volume, I mean number of moles in the tank initially, gas constant, absolute temperature over the pressure. So I'm going to substitute the numbers in here. And so with the units being correct, we get the volume of the tank in cubic centimeters. This then will allow us to determine the final number of moles in the tank. Again, ideal gas law because we know the temperature and the pressure. So the final number of moles in the tank, again, ideal gas law, where now we're using these conditions. So 2.89 moles are left in the tank. And we started with 5 moles. So the number of moles in the cylinder then would be 5 minus 2.89. So we have 2.11 moles in the piston cylinder at the end. This then allows us to write a relationship again from the ideal gas law. So the pressure in the cylinder, of course, the same as the pressure in the tank, the volume of the cylinder, number of moles in the cylinder, gas constant, temperature in the cylinder. There's two unknowns in this equation, but this will be combined now with the energy balance to solve for both of these. So we have a relationship between the volume of the cylinder, the gas at the end, and the final temperature in the cylinder. And now what we want to write down is an energy balance. And this problem is easier to solve for the information we're given if we make an energy balance on the entire system. In other words, entire 5 moles of gas, even though it's in 2 containers at the end. So therefore, it's a closed system, which means delta U, Q plus W for a closed system, because the system's adiabatic, that's zero. And there is work done because we're moving the piston. And so the external pressure is constant. And the volume change is the final volume of the cylinder minus the initial volume, which is zero. And so we're going to calculate delta U for the gas. And what's changed is the temperature. So the delta U for the gas is number of moles times the constant volume heat capacity, CV, because ideal gas delta U is equal to CV delta T. And to be consistent in notation, I should call this delta U total, where now delta U total is going to be number of moles that's in the tank at the end, heat capacity, the final temperature in the tank. So let's call this final minus the initial temperature in the tank. And then we have a similar term for the number of moles that's in the cylinder times the same heat capacity, the temperature of those moles in the cylinder. Initially, those moles were in the tank, so it's the temperature in the tank. And this is then this external pressure times the final volume in the piston and cylinder. We're given CP as 28.8 joules per mole per Kelvin, and CV is going to be CP minus the gas constant. And notice the gas constant has the same numerical value when it's in joules per moles per Kelvin as it does for megapascals cubic centimeters per mole Kelvin. So now we have two equations that we're going to solve simultaneously. One relates the volume in the cylinder to the temperature in the cylinder. The other is the energy balance, and we have two unknowns, the volume and the temperature. So I'm going to substitute numerical values in for the energy balance. Now I'm going to factor out CV. So 20.5 heat capacity times two terms. So I've substituted in the values, the final number of moles in the tank, number of moles in the cylinder. Initially, these moles were in the tank, so their initial temperature is 600 degrees. So we have to be careful now with units. So on the left side, we're going to have joules. The right side, we have pressure and volume. And so we have to do a conversion to put in the same units. But fortunately, one joule is 1 megapascal cubic centimeter. So volume in cubic centimeters, we just have a conversion factor of 1. So now we can do the algebra, and we can make the substitution on the right side at VC. So the right side minus 0.6 times 29.2 times the temperature in the cylinder, finally. And we'll multiply out the left side. Heat capacity was put in denominator on the right side to make the calculations easier. And we end up with a final temperature in the cylinder, 543 Kelvin. So this is significantly different from the temperature in the tank, which is 480 Kelvin. And so the gas cools that expands into the piston and cylinder, also cools that's originally in the tank. Now we're given that temperature of 480 Kelvin, but we could have calculated it if we assume reversible adiabatic expansion for the 2.89 moles. You can visualize that gas being at high pressure, expanding adiabatically reversibly to lower pressure, and using the relationship for reversible adiabatic expansion, where the final temperature over initial temperature is the final pressure over the initial pressure raised to the power of the gas constant divided by CP. So if we substitute the numbers in here, we end up with the final temperature 480 Kelvin. So if we had stated that it was reversible because we cracked the valve and slowly expand the gas, then we would not need to have been given that 480 Kelvin.